Hi, beautiful people. How are ya? I hope you're having a great day. I've got a lot going on. Our oldest granddaughter and her best friend are spending Friday night, which is tonight. I pick her and her friend up at 4 o'clock, and they're staying until the evening on Saturday. My daughter will pick them up because I don't drive at night. And my husband is done after 6 o'clock, so it'll be fun. Teenagers have a lot of energy. I also wanted to update you on that digestive enzyme that I said I was going to start taking. And I got to say, initially I thought, okay, there's a placebo effect going on. And so I wanted to give it a little more time. It's been close to a month, and I haven't had one single tummy ache. A little one night, just a smidgen, and I realized I didn't take the enzyme. You're supposed to take it after every meal. So in my case, usually 3 times a day. This is it. Pure makes it. But I just take one after each meal, and I'll tell you, living without tummy aches is fun. Of course, I think that everything we do should first start with nutrition, having good nutrition first, then add the supplements to supplement. I started putting collagen protein powder in my coffee, and I love it. It tastes really good. I figure I'm getting 2 bangs with my buck. Skin health and muscle and joint support. But today, I want to talk about the human brain and why it's the most important organ in our bodies. Here we go. Our brain is the center of our nervous system. And part of the central nervous system, it sends, receives, and processes messages to control the body. And it also directs sensory information. It floats in our cranium, the skull, in a liquid called cerebrospinal fluid. There are 3 main parts of the brain, the forebrain, which includes the cerebrum and cerebral cortex, the brainstem, and the cerebellum. The brain weighs about 3 pounds and reaches its maximum size when we're about 6 years old. It's made up of 40% water, protein, carbohydrates, and salts, and is the fattiest organ in the body, with 60% fat. It's not a muscle. It contains blood vessels and nerves, including neurons and glial cells. If a person doesn't receive enough oxygen to the brain for 5 to 10 minutes, it will likely cause permanent brain damage and the bursts of a lack of oxygen to my brain gave me optic neuropathy, and why I have that little bit of vision loss. Feels like a lot of vision loss, but it's a section over here on the right side and kind of downward in my right eye. Our brain is more active when we're asleep than when we're awake. Did you know that you can't snore and dream at the same time? Which is one reason why getting sleep apnea under control is so important. The human brain is 60% white matter and 40% gray matter. Gray matter refers to the darker outer portion of our brain, and white matter describes the lighter inner section underneath that. In the spinal cord, this order is reversed, but in our brain, gray matter on the outside of the brain is composed mainly of neuron somas, and white matter contains mostly axons. Neurosomas are the round central cell bodies and axons. They have long stems that connect neurons together. Axons are wrapped in myelin, a protective coating. The protective coating is what is attacked by the immune system in MS, multiple sclerosis, and creates communication problems between your brain and the rest of the body. Neuroinflammation is a different type of inflammation than what you would see in joints and soft tissues. Typical inflammation causes pain like arthritis and MS. Inflammation like this will cause the tissues to expand, putting pressure on the surrounding structures so they hurt. And in neuroinflammation, the same issues don't occur. Instead, neurological problems occur, which cause neurological symptoms. Research over many years has shown that fibromyalgia is due to central sensitization. It's believed that neuroinflammation is behind the central sensitization. What's causing the neuroinflammation? Well, that's a whole other story. So, treatments to reduce or suppress microglia and astrocytes may be helpful. And there are current treatments that might help neuroinflammation. Other medications are under development, but they are potential Parkinson's disease treatments. And anti-inflammatory drugs are often prescribed as well. And let's not forget about small fiber neuropathy. Think about getting checked out for this if you experience stabbing, burning, tingling, and itchy pain that comes and goes. Those symptoms are going to start in your feet and work their way up your legs. These are the same symptoms in fibromyalgia and small fiber neuropathy. If your pain begins in your feet and has moved upward, talk to your doctor. I have an appointment to see a neurologist. I'm doing it in July. So we'll see how that goes. That was the soonest appointment that was available. Currently, researchers are working on drugs called ganglioside GM3 synthase inhibitors. Just remember that autoantibodies have been found in fibromyalgia. I've done several videos on these, so please check them out. And if you could like this video, gosh, it helps the YouTube algorithm the more likes I get. I really appreciate that. I hope you learned something. I certainly did. It's a bit overwhelming how important good brain function is. Since our brain is plastic, meaning it has plasticity and can change the connections in the brain, we play an important role in our own brain health. So let's keep learning. I send you gentle hugs and support. Love you. The brain weighs about three. Gosh, it hit.